Doma Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, you know, I had a little fight in the 140-pound division. You know, Ryan Garcia versus your boy Oscar Duarte. Ryan Garcia, you know, stopped him in round 8. I'm pretty sure you guys are up to speed on that. Ryan Garcia looked pretty good against Duarte. Duarte's a power puncher, coming forward kind of guy. But he was coming forward, doing most of the fight, you know, trying to push the fight. But Ryan, you know, showed some movement, showed some foot speed, hand speed, good jabs, and, you know, kept him off of him, throwing, you know, his speed. You know, Ryan Garcia is a good fighter, man. He got some speed to him, you know what I'm saying, and enough pop to keep people like an Oscar Duarte off of him, you know. So he did a pretty good job throughout the fight. And he's, you know, he stopped Duarte, even though he's coming forward, you know, with a short left, and finished him off pretty well. I think Duarte is going to feel like he got up at 9.5. But at the end of the day, you know, man, you hear the guy fight calling, man, you better stop trying to wait to 9. You know, you might want to start getting up at 7.5, you know, so you can all be for sure you up. You know what I mean? But he was behind in the fight. Oscar Duarte, after about 4 rounds of being totally outboxed, thoroughly outboxed, Oscar Duarte came on, won about 2 or 3 rounds, maybe 2, right? But, you know, the man who was winning the fight was Ryan Garcia. Now, it made a fight a hard watch for one reason, because Ryan Garcia kept turning to the side, right? And he was turning to the side, and I'm thinking, well, you know, somebody going to say what I'm thinking for sure. He would turn to the side, and that means that your boy Oscar Duarte couldn't really throw the right hand at all, because if he was warned for hitting Ryan Garcia in the back, right? So Ryan Garcia just kept turning his back, you know, all the way back, turning your back to him, but halfway, which was limiting Duarte for throwing left hooks, right? Now, if you don't pay attention to what that really means, then he's like, well, it was just limited to throw left hooks then. No, you got 2 hands in the fight, right? If you're not able to throw the right hand the whole time because you're going to hit him in the back, then you're limited. And all Ryan Garcia got to do is block the left hook when he goes down, right? Because he better not hit him in the back, because the referee going to give him a point. That move has to be deemed illegal, or because, you know, it's no way. Because if not, I'm telling y'all what's going to happen. Everybody going to start doing it. You're going to be running around right here like it is in football right now with Philadelphia, with that brotherly shove when they just get it. They need a yard and 4th down, they're just going to shove you. And everybody's starting to try to do it. Be careful. If you can turn to halfway and limited them from throwing a right hand, that means you can't throw a right no more, just a left hook. Is people going to do it. And I think somebody should have said something about that, you know, more that you're not able to throw the right hand. Everybody was talking about, well, you're going to have to throw left hooks. And you have to throw it. No, you don't. That's stand right. If you standing like that, well, I can't only throw a right hand that's going to hit you in the back, then your back is going to be red as hell. You know, it's got to be that. Then the rule has to change. And if you turn your back halfway, then it's open territory. One thing or two going to have to happen. So we know that. But speaking of things people ain't really talking about is what I focused on. It was at the beginning of the fight. I had to rewind it about 18,000 times. I know. Did I hear that? Listen, people. They said Ryan Garcia, the former WBC lightweight champion of the world. That's what they said at the beginning of the fight. Now, I didn't really follow the fight on the build-up in the week, because they ain't championship fight. You know, I didn't follow the weigh-in and you know, the week of talking and all that. I didn't follow it this time. You know, whatever. It's other sport going on. But did they just say Ryan Garcia, former WBC lightweight champion of the world, on national TV, and ain't nobody said nothing about it? Because after that, I just kept listening. Is anybody is going to say, stop. Ryan Garcia was never no damn champion yet. How y'all gonna say former lightweight champion of the world on national TV and nobody say nothing about it? Now, I don't know everything, but I follow a little bit. Now, I can remember Lomachenko was a lightweight champion, WBC style. Didn't want to fight Devin Haney when Devin Haney was the mandatory. Then we came up with something else that was egregious, just like this, the franchise title, which is one of the most things that people didn't say nothing about how bad that was and egregious that was. People just let that go. But we're going to get to some other stuff people just let go. Just let them make up a franchise title. But anyway, so Lomachenko then lost it to Teofimo, but then he had it. The WBC, right? the franchise title. So then Kambosos beat him. Then Kambosos had it, right? And then after that, Kambosos fought your boy Devin Haney. Now he got it, right? And now, you know, he's vacated recently, going up to 140. But my point is, when did Ryan Garcia have it? What Ryan Garcia had was he was the mandatory for Devin Haney, and he never wanted to fight him. So we know that fact. You could have said that before. And was the mandatory challenger 4 years ago, but didn't want the match against Devin Haney. Ryan Garcia, say that then. You don't have to say, you know, something like former lightweight WBC lightweight champion on national TV. That's what's wrong. Nobody say nothing. So you basically selling the fight as, well, you know, he was the champion before he fought Gervonta Davis and lost. That's what you're insinuating. If it's just in case the consumer ain't paying attention, it's like, oh, he was the champion and he got beat by Gervonta Davis, which ain't bad, right? No. He had the opportunity to become a champion a long time ago when his mentor and didn't want to do it. And he was never champion. So those are the things you got to say. But here's the thing about boxing. They know people don't follow it. Because first of all, DAZN anyway, right? You're on DAZN. DAZN, Demetrius Andrade, Canelo Alvarez, Gennady Golovkin, and Jaime Munguia all signed at DAZN. All three of them dudes didn't have to fight Demetrius Andrade. After Demetrius Andrade fight, DAZN's running around talking about Jamal Charlo over at PBC, the other side of the street. And although everybody signed at their side of the street, they didn't say after Demetrius Andrade fights, hey, Canelo, come on, it's easy to make, it's in-house. Gennady Golovkin, Jaime Munguia, it's in-house. Gennady Golovkin, you a unified unification bout. Canelo, you undisputed bout. And Jaime Munguia, you the mandatory for Demetrius Andrade. So all of them had incentive to fight him, right? But we're going to call Jamal Charlo after a fight. That's DAZN, first of all. But here's other things that we just do, right? Manny Pacquiao. My boy, we love some Manny Pacquiao. Eight division champion. See it all the time. You know, eight division champion. You know, so we're going to look away. Ain't nobody paying attention. But he's not an eight division champion unless we're going to count the IBO. Are we going to count the IBO all of a sudden just to say somebody's a champion in there? One of them titles was the IBO. Well, that doesn't count, right? Another thing that shouldn't count is a catchweight fight, right? If you got a catchweight fight, we got way too many divisions. I would be okay with that when we had only like lightweight, welterweight, middleweight, light heavy, and heavy. About five divisions, then you probably can go down to a couple of other under light, maybe, you know, bantam or something. You know what I'm saying? That's about six. Right? But we got all that junior and middle and junior and super and all that stuff in between now. We up to 17 divisions, which means you ain't going to have no catchweight fight, and then we're going to count it as a full division. Why would we want to do that? That's not fair for the people who didn't have that many divisions back in the day. So we're going to call Manny Pacquiao eight divisions. That doesn't sound cool to a person who came up when it wasn't even eight divisions total. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, damn, man, if the dude's still alive, and we're talking about Manny Pacquiao eight divisions, he's like, well, we didn't even have eight divisions. Where did he get those divisions? You know what I'm saying? So if he's going to get the counted for the divisions, can they be full or can they be one of the recognized sanctioning bodies? I mean, if we're asking too much, why are we doing that? Canelo Alvarez right now. I hate to get on Canelo, but it's not about Canelo. It's about the people who's enabling. You know, why are we calling him undisputed? Why are we calling him undisputed in the super middleweight division? One of them damn belts was given to him from the WBC, the same one who gave him the franchise. They gave him the WBC when he fought Callum Smith. Why would we want that? We don't. No, you ain't gonna be called undisputed the same as everybody who fought for all four of their belts. But you're going to the same class as them, and we just gave you one. Why would we even want to do that when we had a person in David Benavidez who we could have fought, who was the champion there? Why would we want to just give him the belt? And then when you know this, you hear this right now, it's two things that's happening. Either you're happy, it's new news, and you're like, oh, man, really? He was given that belt? Or you're like, man, shut the hell up, dude. Shut the hell up, Eze. You know? You're hating. Or whatever. No, you're not. It's just, damn, can we say facts? What is it? Every time facts, what are we, Trump up here? Fake news? Every time you hear something that's factual? But why? Why would we even want that? That's my point. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's a lot of things. I ain't going to mention the fact that they was calling Canelo four division champ when he beat Rory Fielding at 168, and that didn't count because that was a regular title. You know what I mean? But whatever. But he went on to beat somebody who was a real one, like Callum Smith. But beating Callum Smith meant that he would have the three belts. He would have been the WBA or whatever. But the WBC was just given to him. I don't think you think that's fair. Not for real, do you? So it's stuff like that, though, that they will just do. And then they look good for your reactions. You should be outraged. All champions who are real champions and other people who watch boxing to say a champion is something important, right? That we're just not going to just say somebody was a former champion when they weren't. We all in unison don't agree with that. Now, do we? So let's make sure we spread the news. Don't be saying Ryan Garcia is no damn former lightweight champion because he wasn't yet. Got to figure, you know, let him handle his business. He'll get to it because dude's bad. Let's make sure that's clear. I like him. But, you know, no extra stuff. He get enough extra stuff. Don't he got a whole bunch of followers on some social media and stuff? So he's good. But let's make him earn the title like everybody else. Feeling me? Doma Sports Talk Worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.